Welcome to this final video series of the Photovoltaic Systems course. This part is divided into two main topics, grid integration and financial aspects. So first, I will go into some of the issues that arise when we try to connect a PV system to the grid. You will see that some electrical aspects must be taken into account in order to effectively integrate solar energy into a larger energy distribution system. Voltage, frequency, and power require constant control to avoid blackouts or load damage in the grid. In recent years, especially in Europe, governments have been adopting more and more green policies to enhance production from renewable energy sources. It is therefore crucial to combine the intermittent and uncontrollable nature of solar and wind with the energy demand of modern society. Also, PV production is believed to grow exponentially in the next years due to lower prices and a more mature technology. Researchers all over the world are focusing on two main areas to solve the problems that arise when connecting uncontrollable sources like solar power into the grid. The first one is represented by microgrids. Microgrids are defined as a system that includes AC and DC electrical loads, power generators such as photovoltaic, wind, fuel cell, and microturbines, and storage elements like batteries, hydrogen tanks, flywheels, among others. All these components are connected to the grid through a single connection point called the point of common coupling, and are managed by a controller that allows flows of energy within the microgrid and also with the mains grid. Power electronic interfaces play a fundamental role in microgrids, since they convert power from DC to AC and vice versa, making therefore frequency and voltage control possible. The next course of this MicroMaster in Solar Energy Engineering will deal entirely with the aspects of integration of PV systems in the grid by means of microgrids. The second option is HVDC, or High Voltage Direct Current networks. In this case, DC technology is used to transmit electricity at around 220 kilovolts and is meant for long distances and high power production from PV farms or wind farms. There are several advantages when using DC over AC transmission. It is possible to directly implement on and offshore wind power in the system. There is no need for reactive power compensation, which we will discuss in the next video. HVDC also eliminates skin effects on cables. The skin effect is essentially a loss that occurs due to alternating current flowing through long transmission lines. On the other hand, among the disadvantages there is the high cost of converter stations and the fact that HVDC is still a rather immature technology compared to AC transmission. It is also useful to make a comparison on the costs of the AC and DC transmission. If we consider the cost of stations and lines, AC technology shows a relatively low investment cost at the beginning, which increases linearly with the amount of cables needed to cover the transmission distance. On the other hand, DC technology, in red on the graph, requires a high investment to set up the stations, but has a lower cost per kilometer of cables. There is therefore a break-even distance, after which the DC lines are cheaper than traditional AC transmission lines. This distance is usually around 600 to 800 kilometers for cables on land. The second topic of this last section on the PV systems course is focused on the financial aspects of PV systems. The main concepts that we are going to go through is the levelized cost of electricity of PV, the concept of feed-in tariffs and net metering, and finally on the various ways how PV technology can be financed. The prices of solar panels are dropping year after year, mainly due to economies of scale. An empirical law, often called Swanson's Law, can be used to describe the effects of industrial learning on the prices of technology. From the graph, we can see that the price of solar photovoltaic modules tends to drop 20% for every doubling of cumulative ship volume. At current rates, costs halve about every 10 years. This learning curve, backed up by historical data, shows that in the coming years, solar energy is likely to be way cheaper than now, becoming a serious candidate to replace traditional power generations in the energy mix of the countries. Another crucial point for penetration of PV technology is the price of electricity generated. As we are going to see in the next videos, one of the most useful methods to assess this is the levelized cost of electricity. The LCOE describes the effects of investment costs, operating and maintenance costs, interest and inflation rates in the electricity price. In order to increase the competitiveness of PV technology, the aim is to have a low value of LCOE. In 2016, the lowest price of electricity from PV was registered in Dubai and was around 3 US cents per kilowatt hour. So far, we have seen that there are many challenges that PV engineers will have to face in the future, both from the technical and the financial point of view, in order to integrate solar-generated power into the grid. In the next videos, we will go more into these aspects. Let's start with the technical issues of the grid integration of PV.